Hi guys, how are you today? Welcome back to the channel. Welcome to Ram's Life channel. Dosto, I am so good today and I completed my 2 months in the University of Regina and Regina itself, friend. And I'm feeling so good. Next week I'm having a midterm exam and also presentation coming ahead of one particular subject, and I'm so excited about it and I'm enjoying my life over here. Part-time I didn't get yet, friends. It is very difficult for me and all of the other students also, so I will make a particular video on that topic also, friend. But today in this video, friends, we are going to talk about after getting your bus pass, what you are going to do. So there are two things that you should do after getting your bus pass, because in the previous video we have talked about the university procedures and your student ID card and bus pass and everything. So after getting your bus pass, now what you are going to do, it might be your third or fourth day at the Canada or in the University of Regina. So let's see what you should do after getting your bus pass. So two things that you should know after getting your bus pass, two things you should do. First is SIN number. You should go for your social insurance number, and the second is Scotiabank account. Okay, for SIN number, friend, social insurance number you need it for part-time work. Actually, your salary is done by your employer. At that time, the social insurance number is needed, so that you should go for it first. For social insurance number, friends, you have to go to the Service Canada office. You just type on the Google Service Canada office near to your university or college, right? Yeah, in the University of Regina, it is in the downtown of the Regina. Okay, so you should go over there. You don't need to book an appointment. The timing, the service time is around 8 a.m. to 4 p.m. I guess, yes, because I went at 3:30 p.m. and they won't allow me. They said come tomorrow, because SIN number processing takes 40 minutes at least. So they are so here, the time is very important, right? So like, they are so punctual. So I went there at 3:30 and they said no to me. So I went next day again. So make sure you go in a 40 minutes before, actually, right? Because it take 40 minutes to process the SIN number. Okay, what you should remember before going there, you should have your postal code. Means whatever address you are staying in, it doesn't matter. You should not have a permanent address or something. Even I was staying at a housing services of the university, I have given that postal code only. So you have to give the postal code at that Service Canada branch, then only they will allow you. Like, and one more thing you needed is your study permit, original study permit, and original passport copy. So these two things you should keep with you while you are going there, and your address, right? The postal code. Okay, and yeah, they will give you SIN number directly at that time only. After 40 minutes they will it take 40 minutes to process the SIN number. But some cases, because of the system, they will not the SIN number not generated at that time. So in that case, they will send you the SIN number to your address, mail you, right? Post, they will send you in a post, not email, right? So at that time you should say to them that I don't have a permanent address right now, I'm staying in a short stay only because I just arrived in the Canada. So that they will give you a website or something, that on that you can edit your address whenever you are having a new address, right? So just discuss this topic with them, so they will help you with it. Otherwise they will send you to your short stay address only, and then everything will be difficult, right? Okay. And also they will give you more information about the SIN number, how you have to take care of your SIN number, because it is very risky to show SIN number to any other person, because by using a SIN number, any person can order a credit card of your name by connecting your bank account. Yeah, so something is like that. So it is really risky. Once you will go there, they will explain you everything. Okay, so this is all about the SIN number actually. Okay, that second thing is Scotiabank account, your GIC account opening. So there are other banks also in which you can have a GIC account, but majority of the students have a account in Scotiabank only, and I do have in a Scotiabank only. So I am, in this video I am going to talk about a Scotiabank account only. Okay, So now you have a bus pass so that you can go. So what you have to do is search on the Google nearest Scotiabank branch. And I advise you not go to branch directly after searching. You just call to the branch and say them that I want to open my account with you, and I need to book an appointment, so that after getting an appointment you should go there. Don't go directly, because this is how the system works here, okay? So after getting an appointment, you will go there with all your documents, study permit, passport, and your GIC account detail, right? So they will open an account for you. They will provide you the debit card at that time. On the spot, they will give you a debit card, which is actually really good, because cash is really not so much in work over here. Most of the people are using a debit card only. So it is good actually. A debit card you will get at that point only, but credit card they will send you to your address. So at that time also you should make sure about your address. If you are in a short stay, you can tell to the branch that receive my credit card to the branch itself, and then once you will have my credit card, just call me, I will come here and I will collect my card from here, okay? So credit card and SIM card you will get later. SIM card is nothing but it is you will get a point once you start using your credit card. Majority of people are using a credit card here, because if you use credit card then you will get a point, okay? So this is how the system works here. So credit card you will get after 1 week, I guess. Yeah, after 1 week. So make sure you talk about your address properly, because they will send you in a post. So because I made a mistake in that, I gave the address of my university housing services and my credit card went there, and I didn't get my credit card up to 15 days, and then I have to contact to the branch, and then they cancel that previous credit card and they send me a new credit card over here. So make sure about your address when you go to the Scotiabank, okay? Just tell them I don't have a permanent address right now, so just receive my card to the branch only, and once you will receive, call me, so I will collect it from here. So I guess in this video, that's it for today in this video, friends. And this is the two things that you should remember after getting your bus pass. Go for these two things, and then third thing is finding a part-time job, obviously, right? So I didn't get yet. Hopefully I will get soon. I applied almost more than 50 places, but no one is calling for interview also. It is really tough for me, and all the other students are also facing the same problem. So I will make a video on that topic also in the future, friends. And if you have any question, then please ask me in the comment section below. If you like this video, then please don't forget to hit the like button and subscribe to the Rams Life channel, and also follow me on my Instagram. And I hope to see you soon, friends. That's it. Bye bye.